Sharpe in the morning. Jim Sharpe, 550 KFYI.
5 minutes after 5 o'clock. Thanks for being with us here on Sharpe in the Morning.
It's my job as a talk show host to really bring some sanity to the discussion, and at the same time, get a little worked up and get people worked up and be an activist when you see a wrong, like what the federal government is doing in this situation.
All right, well, coming up in just a few minutes here, we're going to be joined by the sponsor of SB 1070, State Senator Russell Pearson. Where we go from here now that the judge has struck down the key parts of SB 1070,
There's a lot of anger out there. A lot of people feel this judge gutted the law. But there's also some positives. I think people are viewing portions of the law that remained intact as a way to actually implement law that we think should have been on the books for a long time, and that is that you can't pick and choose what part of federal law you want to enforce, which some cities in Arizona have chosen to do.
This was never the solution to begin with. This is what's so troubling, that here a job that is already so difficult, that is already so dangerous, and bringing the fight to the drug and human smugglers here, that even take advantage of those illegals, kidnap them, rape them, and all these different things that go on, and we're weakening the laws of our country. We're taking away the tools that law enforcement needs.
The demographics of my show tend to be a little older, a little whiter, a little more Republican than some stations. That tends to be the demographic for a lot of talk radio.
Because that's the case, you know. It doesn't automatically go to the Ninth Circuit. They'll appeal.
This is an issue that rings really soundly with them. And frankly, we're ground zero for illegal immigration in this country. So everybody has a say in this. Everybody has an opinion on illegal immigration.
It's not even official policy in some cases, where we just turn a blind eye because these people may be eventually voting for us. As we like to call them on the show, undocumented Democrats.
Critics who say you're just funneling people's anger. Well, I'm more a sieve for that anger. I rather than just sitting there and complaining and moaning on the phone with listeners, I view my role as an activist. I want to take that anger, I want to take that frustration, and I want to mold it so that we can do something positive with it.
Some news for you here. It doesn't look like National Guard's going to make it to the Arizona border on August 1st. They're going to miss their deadline. Yeah, we were told the troops are going to be down there, and now the Department of Defense and the Department of Homeland Security, despite announcing 10 days ago that the National Guard will show up at the border on August 1st, they say we don't have any units to deploy by August 1st. We don't know yet.
I think radio is a very intimate medium. I think it's one that I think people feel like they get to know you a little better, because when it's just your voice, you know, you're getting the real deal. You know, and it's one of the ways I think that makes it such an effective communication tool.